There is an old wives' tale which says that boys cause more problems during labor than girls. So the question is that true? Or is it rather the girls who cause those problems?
Yes, so in this video we are going to give you the answer to that question. And we also explain why scientists believe that things are as they are.
Yes, and finally we're also going to tell you what you can do to reduce the risk that a certain fetal sex causes troubles when you're in labor. Mm-hmm. This is Nathalie, a pregnancy and birth consultant and TCM therapist.
And that's Mathias, a researcher and science geek. Can we help expecting mummies and their babies naturally and science-based?
So is it the boys or is it rather the girls? I'm not gonna lie to you, I really thought it's the other way around, but no, studies clearly show that it's the boys who tend to cause more problems during labor. Actually, not only during labor, but also already while you're still pregnant, right?
Yes. As for pregnancy-related complications, a recent review study which included over 12 million women found that boys are more likely to cause problems such as preeclampsia, gestational diabetes, gestational hypertension, placental abruption, and postpartum hemorrhage.
Yes, as for labor itself, other scientists found that there is a higher risk for women who carry boys that labor does not progress. They're also more likely to have instrumental deliveries as well as C-sections. But don't worry, we are gonna tell you later in this video what you can do about it. Mm-hmm. But yes, in a nutshell, it seems that it is more difficult to deliver a baby boy. So it's actually the boys who can cause troubles, not the girls, unlike later in life, right?
Well, at least girls grow up eventually. Boys will always be boys.
Yeah, well, I'm not the one who sleeps with a Mickey Mouse-shaped hot water bottle. Anyways, what did we talk about? Oh, yes, so here's the $1 million question. Why do boys cause more troubles than girls when they are in the womb? Because if we know the answer to that question, it may also give us an idea about what we can do about it, right?
Yes. Well, scientists have not yet found a definite answer. However, there is an increasing number of studies which come to the conclusion that boys and girls take different pathways when they are in the womb.
Yes, to be precise, it seems that if you are pregnant with a boy, your body, and in particular your placenta, creates an environment in your womb which is designed to maximize the growth of your baby. However, this happens at the cost of the adaptability. Mm-hmm. In other words, baby boys seem to be less able to adapt to changes in the womb, right?
Yes. Girls, on the other hand, seem to be much more adaptable to changes in the environment, and because of that, they seem to be less susceptible to certain complications. But this happens at the cost of growth. As a result, it is not surprising that girls are more likely to suffer from fetal growth restriction compared to boys.
Yeah, so what does this mean for you and for your final weeks of your pregnancy and for your labor, right? And most importantly, what can you do about it? Well, if baby boys find it more difficult to adapt in the womb, and also because they tend to be bigger than baby girls, chances are that they find it more difficult to find a good position for labor.
Yes. In addition, because boys tend to be bigger when they are born, there is a tendency for labor to be a bit more difficult and potentially more painful compared to delivering a girl.
Yes, and according to scientists, the focus on growth and size could also explain why carrying a boy seems to involve a higher risk that labor does not progress during both the dilation and the pushing phase. Mm. And by women carrying boys are therefore more likely to have instrumental deliveries or even a C-section.
Yes. And if you follow our channel, you obviously already know how these two things, baby's position and progressing in labor, are linked. At the end of your pregnancy, we want your baby to be in a position that allows baby's head to eventually be well applied onto your cervix, particularly once you are in labor.
Exactly, because then your contractions are effective. Mm. They can do their job and open your cervix. And this is what keeps labor going and what keeps labor progressing, right? But don't worry, because even if your labor does not progress, there are many, many things that you can do to help your baby find a better position to make your labor more effective. Mm-hmm. More info about that in the description below this video. Anyways, obviously the best thing would be if none of those complications happen in the first place, right? So the question is, what can you do to reduce the risk that any of those complications happen.
Yes, so first of all, we clearly want to point out that even if you are pregnant with a boy, please do not worry. Even when scientists say that the risk for those complications to occur is higher in pregnancies with boys, well, that does not mean that any of this is going to happen to you, yeah. Okay? And it also doesn't mean that these things won't happen to you if you're pregnant with a girl. We are just talking about a slightly higher probability if you're pregnant with a boy.
Yes. Second, there are several things that you can do to reduce the risk. Mm-hmm. Most importantly, do what we always tell you to do on our channel, and you're probably already very tired to hear it again, but when you prepare for your delivery during the final weeks of your pregnancy, focus on two things, your baby's position and your cervix.
Exactly. Well, actually, there are several things to focus on when you prepare for your delivery. Yeah. But when it comes to the complications that we just discussed, yes, focus on these two things. So first, help your baby find a good position for labor. And really, we would do that no matter if you have a boy or a girl.
Yeah.
Moreover, we are not only talking about helping baby turn head down, we also want your baby to face your back instead of your front, for instance, mm-hmm. right? You can find several videos on this topic on our channel that you can find below this video.
Right. Next, prepare your cervix for labor from week 37 onwards. The sooner your cervix is soft, the sooner it can start to dilate. And if your baby is always in a good position for labor, the additional pressure from your baby's head on your cervix will basically do the rest, yeah. right? This can help you with a spontaneous start of labor.
Yes, and if we then also support your baby during labor, so the baby can move more easily through your pelvis, well, then there is normally really nothing to worry about progressing labor or to have an instrumental delivery or even a C-section.
Yes, when it comes to pregnancy-related complications on the other hand, such as preeclampsia, gestational diabetes or gestational hypertension, etc., well, these are the kinds of problems which are just very, very difficult to prevent, right?
Yes. However, there are factors which make it more likely to suffer from those, no matter if you have a boy or a girl. So the best thing you can do to reduce the risk of such problems are a healthy nutrition, exercising and managing your pregnancy weight.
Yes, and again, you can find a whole list of videos to help you with that in the description below this video. Mm-hmm. Most importantly though, focus on your cervix and your baby's position.
Yeah.
For example, watch the video on the best sitting position to help baby find a good position for labor.
Right. If you have found this video helpful, we would be super grateful if you could leave us a like below this video.
Yes. And for more useful tips and tools on pregnancy and baby-related topics, make sure to subscribe to our channel and to hit the bell.